Hello everyone, this is Akang Suman here. Now we are going to discuss analysis of the involute gears. We already covered involute profiles, okay, and the law of gearing. What is the law of gearing? The line of action must pass through the pitch point. Pitch point is on the line connecting two center of rotations, okay. So here you can see this is a involute gear profile, and here you can see there is a line of action. This is in that direction when two gears are in mating condition. One gear exert a force upon another gear, so that would be in that direction. So here you can see line of action is like that. You can see the line of action is passing through the pitch point. It must pass through the pitch point in order to satisfy the law of gearing. Okay, and one another thing that you have seen here, the line of action is tangent to base circle. Here you can see there is a point M and there is a point N. This is the point M and this is the point N. Okay, are you getting my point? So this is the line of action which is passing through the pitch point, as well as it is the tangent to the base circle. So I'm going to write at the start of the engagement. I'm talking about the start of engagement period. What will happen from the start of the engagement to the end of the engagement? We will see. That is the analysis of the involute gear. At the start of the engagement, line of action. First point I am going to write here, that line of action must pass. This is the law of gearing. So in the diagram, I am talking about the diagram. So line of action is passing. Is passing through the pitch point, that means law is satisfied, law of gearing is satisfied. Passing through the, if you found any doubt, you can ask to me. Line of action is passing through the pitch point, and pitch point is always a fixed point, we all know that. Pitch point, or you can say fixed point. Okay, that is the fixed point. On the line connecting two center of rotations, okay. So that is the, and as well as, and it is tangent to the base circle. So the next point is tangent to the base circle. Okay, so that is the first point we have seen in the diagram at the start of the engagement. See, when there is a start of the engagement between mating gears, the first point at the start of the engagement is, I am going to consider, that is K. K is here, that is the start of the engagement period. Okay, at the start of the engagement, there will be a point K I am going to consider. And when there is an end of the engagement, there will be a point L here. You can see this is the L. So that means the mating gears, when both are going to in a contact to each other, there will be engagement periods. So when we start from K to the end of the K, end of the L, that would be the full engagement period. Are you getting my point? So here point of contact is changing. Initially the point of contact is at Q. Okay, so suppose this is the like that, and that will move for some time. That will in contact, they will in contact for some time. Okay, so from A to L, both the mating gears are in contact to each other, but the contact point will be changing. Contact point is continuously changing. Okay, but the line of action is not changing. When you define the line of action here, that will not be changing with the contact, with the mating gear motions. Okay, for a one engagement period, that will not change. Line of action will not change for one engagement period. Okay, so there is a starting point K and the ending point L. So here from, we will start from K to L, and the continuously point of contact is changing. For example, I am going to consider a random point of contact, that is Q here. So initially Q is at K, and finally Q will be at L. Are you getting my point? So that is, you can see the path of the contact point. You can see the path of contact, the path of point of contact Q is along the straight line. Okay, Q will be here, there, and at P, and after, and at the end of the engagement period, K will be at L. So here point of contact is changing, but it is traveling along the line of action. Are you getting my point? Here this is the line of action. So what would be the locus? You can say locus of point of contact. What would be the locus of a point of contact? You must remember that locus of point of contact in the involute gear, the locus of point of contact in the involute gear is a straight line. Are you getting my point? So some points are I'm going to written here. So you must remember that point of contact is changing, but the line of action is not changing. Okay. So here I'm going to write that point of contact is traveling along a straight line. Point of contact is traveling along a straight line. Since it is traveling along a straight line, so what would be the path of the point of contact along the straight line? That would be straight line, yes or no? Straight, but this is only for involute profile. Okay, so here point of contact is changing, but the line of action is not changing for one engagement period. Line of contact is changing, but line of action is not changing. So what will happen? What would be the locus of the point of contact? So next point is locus of point of contact. Locus of point of contact will be kya hoga? Straight line. Okay, so that is the analysis of the involute profile. Now we will find out from this analysis of the involute profile, we will calculate the path of contact and the path of recesses and the path of the approach. Everything we will see, and from this analysis of the involute profile, we will discuss about the arc of contact and the contact ratio also. So see here in the diagram, you can see there is a point of contact which is traveling from K to L. Okay, so there will be a time interval, yes or no? So I am saying the time interval in which Q is traveling from the start of the engagement, or you can say start of the engagement to the end of the engagement, or you can say the time travel in which Q is traveling from the one engagement period. Okay, both things are same. So I am going to write here that time interval. Time interval in which Q is traveling. Q is traveling from start to end of the engagement. What will say this time interval? End of engagement. What will say this? Engagement, that will be considered as one engagement period. That would be one engagement period. Okay, and the distance traveled by the point of contact in this period is considered as a path of contact. The distance, this is the time interval in which Q is traveling from the start to the end of the engagement, that is considered as a one engagement period. That would be one engagement period. And this is the complete length, that means the traveling length of the point of contact from K to L.